jockstrap.
Oh. Huh?
In your jockstrap.
Oh God, I completely forgot. I'm steaming up. God, I'm just literally coming from the shop.
I was going to say, do you know you've got a jockstrap on your face?
It does feel like wearing a gusset. I know how much you love certain types of films.
Mm. And how much I hate other types of films.
Precisely.
It isn't a horror.
No, well, there's something about this film that when I tell you the title of it, you're going to go,
Oh no!
Okay. Yeah. But then I know that when you watch it, it's potentially, Maddie's not here tonight, it's potentially going to become one of the films that we're most excited about.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So this is a film called Hillbilly Elegy.
Oh no, I can't burn. That's my most hated thing. Is somebody going to be taken off to a hilly-billy place and then kept there against their will? I don't like them.
Don't you love how well I know you?
Mark, please don't.
Yeah, can I just clear that?
Is there going to be anything like...
No.
What's that awful film that I saw the beginning of? When they break down and then they go, they'll come and they take her off.
The Hills Have Eyes? Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
Hills Have Eyes. I don't
Okay. know. This is hillbilly in the true original American historical sense of the word. This is a hillbilly elegy. It's based on a book that was a huge success, New York Times bestseller. It stars, and this will start to tug you in the right direction.
Is it like the Ozark hillbillies? I can just about bear that hillbilliness, but I find that too hard.
It stars Glenn Close.
Oh, love Glenn
Close. Who we loved in The Wife, didn't we? With Jonathan Price. I thought she was absolutely sensational in that. It stars Amy Adams.
Ah, now you're winning me round.
Now I'm winning you round. And it tells the story from the point of view of the son of Amy Adams and the grandson of Glenn Close as he returns to his Appalachian Mountain family. His mum is an addict and it's a family in breakdown. It's a Netflix film, and it's kind of come out in the quiet. It's directed by Ron Howard, you know, Ron Howard of Happy Days. Ron Howard, yeah, absolutely.
And happy... How's it go? I can't remember it.
Monday, Tuesday, happy days.
Wednesday, Thursday,
and of course, Ron Howard has become a very capable director. Most recently...
Very more than that. He's done some brilliant...
And most recently...
And he's got a really good son, a really good actor.
Daughter. Bryce Dallas Howard, who of course is in Jurassic World and Jurassic Park. She's directed some
mad.
Of the Mandalorians. Yeah,
made me feel really old when I was.
When you knew that his, and also his daughter is nearly like 30 or 40.
Don't, please don't.
What the hell? What the hell's going on? So everything about this looks great. I've seen a snippet and I know that Maddie, the little empathetic actress she is going to be absolutely on this because they're talking about this as a potential Oscar contender in this curious world. And this curious sort of season where are there going to be any Oscars? So this is another Netflix film directed by Ron Howard, starring Amy Adams, Glenn Close, The Hillbilly Elegy. Sorry, stay strong.
Oh, I thought your mama was going to be all right. Be happy. I know I could have done better. But you got to decide you want to be somebody.
I've been doing real good. I just had a down month.
I got an interview tomorrow, Mom. Otherwise, I...
Oh, you know me. I always land on my feet.
Don't look at that. Come on. Come on. Don't you look at me. You look at me. You look at me.
You let her get away with this every time.
I told you that I would do better.
You always say that. You're lying.
I always try.
You gotta think about these kids.
What do you think I've been thinking about since I was 18 years old, huh? Never had a life where I wasn't thinking about the kids.
Do you actually want to be dead, Mom? Or are you just too lazy to try?
Jamie? Oh, I tried! Plenty!
You always got a reason. It's always someone else's fault. Some point, you're gonna have to take responsibility. Or someone else is gonna have to step in.
Who, huh? You?
Hasta la vista, baby.
How many times you've seen this?
Oh, about 100. Everyone in this world is one of three kinds. Good Terminator, a bad Terminator, and neutral.
You're a good Terminator.
Well, it wasn't always. I had to learn. You could too.
I love you. I promise that I'm gonna do better.
Honey, you gotta write your own life.
Don't make us your excuse, JD.
Family's the only thing that means a goddamn. You learn it.
Wow. You know me so well. Love it. Can't wait for it.
Oh, and it's that old narrative of the loved grandmother it. Stepping in and him connecting to the grand. It's a bit like my... Obviously, Nanny Di wasn't quite like that. But that I can. It gets me immediately when I see that connection. Sorry.
Oh, sweetie. Oh. Smart lost his nan a couple of years ago. Oh, sweetie. Okay.
Whoa, sorry about that.
Isn't that the joy of movies? Movies make us feel something. Good movies do. And you lost your nan 2 years ago now. Mm. And there's a similarity to what went on as in that film. And and great filmmakers hold a mirror up to people. And so, I can't wait for this film.
Glenn Close looks absolutely phenomenal. And that sort of hardened, wizened kind of wisdom. And
she looked a bit like she had a bit too much prosthetics.
Maybe a little bit.
I don't know what they did to her.
And it looks a bit like Amy Adams is sort of... This is a continuation of the part that she was playing in Sharp Objects. And this is like the logical extension.
Sharp Objects.
And the boy looks very good. So that looks incredibly, incredibly powerful. Incredibly powerful.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.